Welcome back to Sim UK. This is Fernbus Coach Simulator, and today I'm going to give away another copy of the Neoplan Skyliner. So I need a bit of a video in order to put over the back of this. Now, some of you have been insinuating and highlighting that I'm holding you to ransom, making you watch videos to see the draw. I just thought I was making an interesting video and putting the draw in with it. So, okay, fine, I get you. So, although you'll be watching this video in the background, all that's going to happen today is the draw, and this will just be in the background. If you want to watch it, watch it. If you don't want to watch it, don't watch it. And to make life easier for you, I'm going to put the name of the winner in the comment section. So if you can't even be bothered to watch the draw, just look in the comment section. To be quite honest with you, if you don't want to come and watch the videos, don't come and watch the videos. I certainly don't want you here against your own will. That's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to drive really short route, Frankfurt to Darmstadt. But that'll probably take 5 minutes, and the draw will only take 2 minutes. And if you've already looked in the comment section and your name's not the winner, then you've probably left already, so no problems. Let's create a new route, route name, blah, whatever. Oh crikey, why does the map zoom out? That is so frustrating. I cannot wait until they sort that out. Darmstadt, there we go. It's gonna take 40 minutes in travel time. That's probably 4 minutes in real life, I don't know. Although, knowing me, I'll probably take the wrong turn and end up in Frankfurt or something. Anyway, let's go. Today, I'm going to be taking my new paint out. This is the Skyliner. That's the name of the repaint, the Skyliner. This repaint, incidentally, is the one that was used when the Skyliner was shown off at exhibitions prior to actually being released. I've just realised. Oh, no, they're okay. So yeah, this is one of my repaints. This is available on the Steam Workshop now. If you want to go pick it up, you're welcome to do so. I have another one which is kind of under development. This looks terrible, this bit. And there's some tidying up to do as well. But you get the general idea. That needs sorting out. I'm not happy with these plants, but this is based on the old style Skyliner, the previous model. So not the Neoplan Skyliner, but just the Skyliner. I thought it looked pretty cool, so I tried to build that. And the wheels need sorting out as well. But there's a few bits to be done here, but that's another repaint that I've put up. Now, the other repaint that you'll see for me at the moment for the Skyliner is... Oh, I've turned it off. Let's go back. Let's go back, and there it is, the wireframe. So if I just go in and show you this. Oh God, yeah, sorry, I know, it's like I'm holding you to ransom, I do apologise. For those of you who are interested in any of this stuff, then, you know, I'll just keep going. But for the rest of you, just look in the comment section, there's the name of the winner there, so you don't have to watch any of this rubbish. So this crazy repaint that you're seeing here is something that I did very early on when repaints first came out. And it's to help, it's primarily to help new people who are interested in doing repaints. Now you can, I call it the color-coded wireframe, although that's not what it says there, that's a mistake. And basically, when you look at the PSD file, you can identify certain parts of the coach. Like, you'll know this is, this purple bit is this side, and the red bit is this side, and the yellow bit is this rear panel, and this kind of off yellow is the other side of the rear panel. And then, do you see what I mean? So it's for those of you who want to do repaints but you don't know what you're doing, and it just quickly and easily just opens it all up for you so that you can start to get to grips with it very early on. Now I'm building a template as well, which will have loads of stuff pre-built in it, like these strippy lines. That's going to be in the template, so you can turn that on and off. You can just change the colors of it, you know. Basically, it's unlimited what you can do. You can do anything you like here. But that's another story. That's coming soon. I'm going to put up a tutorial explaining how I do repaints so that you guys can join in as well. Because the more repaints we have, the better. Whether they're good, bad or indifferent, it doesn't matter. The more you have, the better it is. Especially now that any repaints you have currently active, and that's why I turned... That is why I turned this one off. Any repaints that you have active or enabled, sorry, will show up in game. Now that's a bit of a crazy one, the color-coded wireframe, so I don't want that in game. Anyway, that's enough babble, especially for such a short video, but yeah, let's start the game and do this very short route. So here we are, guys. This is the Skyliner repaint. It's very loud. I think maybe I had my my earphones up far too loud. So this is the repaint. It's based on a real life Neoplan on the real life Neoplan Skyliner repaint that was developed and designed for exhibitions prior to the release of the Skyliner. I think it looks quite nice. It's pretty. I mean, it's not over the top, there's not too much going on, it just looks stylish. I really like it. Anyway, I'm not here to promote that. Now I've been thinking, because some people really don't appreciate the videos, I'm not gonna do the giveaway in this video. I'm gonna do a totally different giveaway and in another video, and that's going to be in there. So if you don't want to watch this, just don't watch it. It's not a problem. But I'm actually going to do a video today because I actually genuinely enjoy this game, and I really like the experience. And so much good stuff has happened. There's a new sound engine. I assume you can hear that. It's quite, sounds like white noise at the moment, but now this is a test that they did. I'm going to show you this now. Let me just start the engine up. This is the new sound engine. You can hear the engine, and then as I go around the back, obviously it will get quieter. Changes, and then as we come around this side, so like so. So that's pretty much the test of the new sound engine. It makes the sound of vehicles passing you and vehicles that you pass sound a lot better as well. There's lots of good stuff. And I've just realised, again, that I've forgotten to put my head tracking on. Oh, wow. Okay, we're good. Get the door closed. Let's get in gear. Handbrake off. And away we go. Alrighty then. Suppose we ought to turn the lights on. Now, we're going to be going to the airport first. Interesting, no sounds there. I'm not sure what's going on with the sound engine right now. I'll be totally honest with you, it sounds a bit weird to me at the moment. Let's open the window. I mean, that sounds better, definitely. Birdies. You won't hear birdies in the coach anymore, unless you've got the window open. The sound engine has improved. Now, something else has happened that they haven't even announced in the release notes, is that Not only will coaches appear at bus stations. I'm going right here, not left. Go. I'm not sure what's going on with the engine sounds. They're really weird. Let's close this window. We don't need any fuel, thank you. So it seems like I'm turning right here. Now, when we get up onto the motorway, hopefully, if we're lucky, you'll see some other coaches driving. Maybe even some Neoplans, I don't know. But it's a fantastic addition to the game. It really, really makes it feel more realistic and more alive. But there's no mention of it in the release notes, or not that I've seen anyway. So we're coming off the motorway straight away here, so we probably won't see a coach right now. What the hell's that noise? Looks like I've got a flat tyre. Weird. Bit weird. Oh look, here comes a coach. And it is a Neoplan. I'll just slow down, let it pass. Oh no, it's not. But look at that! That is brilliant. For me, that's epic. The fact that he just overtook me and cut me up is irrelevant. I love to see other coaches driving on the motorways. That's brilliant. And he's actually driving off the motorway as well, so maybe you'll see them in town too. That's a massive improvement, I think. Massive improvement. Right, so I'm assuming just down here on this stretch is where, oh my god, that was terrible. Is where we'll find the most, the airport, sorry. I feel like there's a chicane coming, there it is. Oh, I don't know which way I'm going. Straight on. Now, I was deliberately quiet then. Because the sound of trucks passing you, that's improved immeasurably. I think the sound, the engine of the, the sound of the engine whilst you're, there was flowers in the road then. The sound of the engine as you're driving is a bit unimpressive, let's say. I'm not massively impressed with the sound I'm hearing right now. Maybe that's accurate, maybe it isn't, I'm not entirely sure, but what's happening outside, fantastic, audio-wise. Trucks passing you, trucks in front of you, I mean, you can really hear it. Maybe you can hear it a bit too much, sort of, you can hear it over the sounds of the engine of the coach that you're actually driving. I think maybe that's where the issue is. So here's Frankfurt Airport. This is where we're turning off. Just let that lorry in front disappear-io. Did I miss my turning? No, here it is. Okay. Here we go. Now, I've heard rumours that the Neoplan Skyliner is too tall for Frankfurt Airport. So there's a good chance that we'll discover whether or not that's true right now. Let me just zoom in a second. So I'm going on this one, the inner lane. Is that right? Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Here we go. So, just change my camera a tad. Oh wow, that's not the, oh my god! Well, I don't know where these, whereabouts it is too low. I thought it would be here, but it seems fine to me. You know, if anything, there's loads of headroom. I think the sound engine is a good improvement, but it needs a bit of tweaking. I mean, why am I hearing birds now? If there's one place you don't expect to find birds, it's at an airport. They're kind of, they're not that keen on birds at airports, so I've discovered. Everybody's waiting patiently. Make sure I give myself some room to get out because of that taxi. We'll open up the side doors and get everybody in. I think I need to log in first. Can't imagine why anybody wouldn't want to watch this. There's been so many mistakes already. Oh, and I nearly clicked start ride. Really need to stop doing that. Oh, really? I didn't set the coach up at all, did I? Sorry, guys. It's, there we go. Happy now? Express check-in, sir. That was a bit blurry, madam. Incidentally, guys, if you haven't seen the most recent dev diaries from TML, you should definitely check it out, because there's a snippet there of the new NPCs, the passengers that you're going to see, and my word, they look good. Why is it doing that blurry thing? I haven't seen that before. It's okay, you're going to take another bus. Snotty. And finally, this lady here. So not only are they bringing NPCs, but also the NPCs are going to be walking onto the coach, putting their luggage in the back, all that kind of stuff, which I think is brilliant. Right, let's close that door. I seem to have got up out of my seat. That's weird. I don't know how I did that. Maybe I've bound it to a button. Right, sorry about that. I'd accidentally turned off the head tracking. silly place to park. Right, now where the... Where did you come from? You crazy fool. You don't drive through buses like that. Okay, we're going right here. What would be amazing is, in the future there will be, if, oh God, I cannot see which way I'm going. Kind of straight over. If when you have an accident, you have to stop and wait for the police to turn up, and obviously that will, I mean, they don't have to animate that or anything, you just, say you lose 15 minutes of your drive time. And obviously incur some point loss and rather than visual damage to the bus, because I know FlixBus are highly anti having any damage to any of their buses in this game, then, you know, maybe just have the repairs, the cost of the repairs taken out of your profits, that kind of thing. But all in the future. There's a lot of good stuff coming this way, and I think Fernbus is going to be a real top quality simulator. He says as this plant's growing out of the floor in the middle of the road, but that's quite normal. So anyway, all this area that we're in now, I've never driven in before. My God, they're complaining about the speed. You can turn that off now, incidentally. You can turn it off so that oh God, I thought I was going to hit that. I nearly hit that car. That was terrible driving. Got away with it though, just about. Come on. So this is nice. This is a nice bit of area. Oh, proper bouncy. What would be nice also is if, obviously if the coach bounces, that's fine, but it would be nice if your head bounced as well, like you see in flight simulators, where they simulate turbulence on the aeroplane. But also that has a knock-on effect to your visual stability. So rather than, as we saw just then, the bus bouncing up and down, it would be a combination of us jiggling about and also the bus bouncing up and down. I think that would look far more realistic, for obvious reasons. It's quite a cool little intersection, really. Now this journey shouldn't take too long, but what I want to do is just go around and start unlocking cities which I don't currently have access to. Oh, and the lights just about went green. That was a combination of trying to figure out the GPS and not knowing how the roads intertwine here. Honestly, I am trying to stay in one lane. I'm all over the place. And now I'm speeding. This ain't Formula One. They've given the NPCs, like... Oh, we're turning left here. They've given the NPCs... like a London-based accent via the translations. I wonder if TML have got like a resident interpreter who's actually from London. Oh, this ain't from You ain't bloody Formula One, are you, mate? Jesus Christ! That's my London accent interpretation. It's not very good. I do better ones. I used to be very good at accents. Whoa, Nelly. Not so much anymore. So this is pretty cool. Anyway, look at this. There's like a, I don't know, like a central shopping area. This is kind of cool. I'd like to live here. There's hardly any people about. Traffic or pedestrian. And that's quite an impressive building there, whatever that is. So guys, this is the end of the ride here. Hope you've enjoyed it. It's not been brilliant. I'm a bit out of sorts today. Been trying to sort out the drawer for the Neoplan, and it was a bit more complicated than I initially anticipated. Incidentally, guys, on Wednesday I'm doing a draw for the Fernbus Coach Simulator game, and I've kind of decided, actually, in the last 2 minutes. Excuse me, there's another coach there, look. I've decided in the last 2 minutes to give away a copy of Fernbus Coach Simulator and the Neoplan as one package. Now, I've never said I was going to do that, and I've only just decided that I'm going to do that, but I think it's a good idea, I think it's fair. Thank you so much for travelling with us today. It's been a pleasure. Au revoir. They're all just going to stand there, okay. So, on Wednesday, somebody's going to win a copy of Fernbus Coach Simulator. Plus, what the heck? Sit down. Why won't you sit down properly? A copy of Fernbus Coach Simulator and a copy of Neoplan Skyliner. But there are only 28 people in the draw. So one of you is definitely going to be in with a very good chance of winning the lot. So anyway, that's it from me today, guys. Not the best video ever, perhaps. I apologise for that. But hopefully you enjoyed some of it. And we've opened up a new city. And next week, or tomorrow even, I'll do another short jaunt and open up another city. Till then, take care. Bye-bye for now.